Most of us will have heard stories about haunted houses, cemeteries, hospitals and hotels. But did you know there are also many roads that boast their fair share of ghouls too? From the ghosts of murder victims and suicide, to phantom children, spectral cops, and hellhounds, the following roads are considered to be among the most haunted highways on the planet. Wakehurst Parkway, Australia. We begin our ghostly road trip down under in Australia with the Wakehurst Parkway. This winding road is situated in New South Wales, and connects the towns of Narrabeen, and Seaforth. It is not far from Sydney, but is a little bit off the beaten track, and when the sun goes down, it falls into almost total darkness. Crashes happen frequently, and the road also has a murderous past. There have been many reports of unusual phenomena happening on this particular stretch of highway. Drivers have claimed that their windscreen wipers have suddenly stopped working, radios switch on and off, and cars lock and unlock themselves. Then there are the ghostly apparitions. Travelers on the Wakehurst Parkway have reported the terrifying sight of either a young or old woman suddenly appearing in the rearview mirror. Local legend has it that the older of the two is the ghost of a Scottish nun who died on the road decades ago. The younger woman is the spirit of a hitchhiker named Kelly, who was murdered on the road during the 1970s after being picked up by her killer. Kelly usually appears after dark. Motorists see her standing by the side of the road, and realizing they have passed a lone woman in the dark, they look in the rearview mirror to try and spot her. All of a sudden she appears on the back seat of the car, her distinctive eyes staring back in the mirror. However, when the driver turns around, she has disappeared. The ghost of Kelly was the subject of a 2015 movie, The Parkway Hauntings, but even during filming, the cast and crew experienced some unsettling unexplained events. Filmmaker Bianca Biasi said filming in Deep Creek Reserve was terrifying. It was freaky, says Bianca. We had a psychic medium with us, and she described in detail that someone had been murdered there. All of a sudden the actors started behaving strangely. A couple started vomiting, and we considered hospitalizing one because it was so hard to calm her down. Something instinctively told me to get them out of there, it was eerie. I've been to a lot of haunted places and there is something very eerie about that place. There is definitely darkness there. Aside from the murder of hitchhiker Kelly, the nearby Deep Creek Reserve has been the scene of some of Australia's most heinous murders. In August 1994, 34-year-old Stephen Dempsey was shot with a crossbow by murderer Richard Leonard, who then dismembered his body and stored it in a freezer. However, in December, Leonard and his girlfriend Denise Shipley took the body parts and dumped them in the suburb of Pittwater. Police eventually linked Richard Leonard to another murder, and upon searching his home, found the bow and arrow that matched the one used to kill Dempsey. A year later, in March 1995, the remains of 21-year-old Frances Tiswan, who had been strangled by her ex, was found dumped near the parkway. The road also has connections with the 1963 murder of 8-year-old Graham Thorne, who was abducted and killed in a botched ransom attempt after his parents had won $100,000 on the lottery. His personal effects and school bag were found strewn across the highway, and his body was later found 1.5 kilometers away. Clinton Road, New Jersey, USA. This secluded 10-mile stretch of highway is certainly not one you would want to drive alone at night. With no signs of civilization in sight and with few places to turn off once you're on it, Clinton Road is one of the spookiest roads in America. According to legend, the road and its surrounding areas have been used by clansmen, witches, and devil worshippers. In fact, even though the building was demolished decades ago, prior to 1988, Cross Castle was said to be the main meeting place of a group of devil worshippers. Who knows what evils have been unleashed during their satanic rituals. There have been reports of sightings of hellhounds and the elusive Jersey Devil in the area too. Also commonly reported are sightings of a ghost boy. He spends his time near the bridge by Clinton Brook. Many have reported seeing his reflection in the water. Legend has it that if you throw coins into the water, he will throw them back. In some tellings, an apparition is seen, in others, the ghost pushes people into the water if they look over the side of the bridge, in order to save them from being run over, as he was in life. The infamous ghost boy isn't the only ghost said to haunt this particular stretch of road. Legend has it that two park rangers were killed just off the road and that they still patrol the area. Another story claims that a ghost Camaro driven by a girl who supposedly died when she crashed it in 1988, appears while driving the road at night if you mention the story. Other phantom vehicles include pickup trucks or even floating headlights that supposedly appear from nowhere in the middle of the night, and chase drivers to the end of the road, then disappear. The A75, Scotland. The A75 is reputedly the most haunted highway in Scotland. There have been screaming hags, eyeless phantoms and a menagerie of unearthly creatures witnessed on this famous road. In fact, documented reports of ghosts on this road go back at least 50 years. A common sighting was groups of dejected, disheveled people hauling handcarts or carrying bundles, like some medieval camp followers. One driver was so shocked by what he saw, he gave up truck driving altogether. He had been parked on the Kinmount Strait, and had woken up at 3 in the morning, and he saw this parade of people. He said that it went on for ages and had terrified him to the core. Other strange phantom figures have also been reported on the A75. In 1957, a truck driver thought he had collided with a couple walking arm in arm along the road, but they had vanished when he stopped to check. A few people have reported seeing the couple, sometimes dressed in Victorian clothing, and the man missing his eyes. In 1995, Garston and Monica Miller were driving home along the A75, when a strange figure appeared on the road before them. It was a man in hessian sack, holding a rag out towards the couple's car as they came towards him. They thought they had struck the man, but couldn't find anything. However, the most infamous supernatural experience took place in 1962. Brothers Derek and Norman Ferguson experienced 30 minutes of baffling encounters as they drove along a stretch of the road known as Kinmount Strait. It began with a large hen flying towards their windscreen. Then, from out of nowhere, an old woman ran towards the car, waving her arms. This was followed by a menagerie of creatures including cats and wild-looking dogs. Unnerving laughter was heard, their car began to rock violently, and the brothers reported a chill in the air. To top off the bizarre incident, the men thought they were going to collide with a van. But it disappeared just before impact. It is not just the road that is haunted. Workers in the gift store at Gretna's famous blacksmith's shop have experienced supernatural happenings since the partition wall was knocked down nearly 2 years ago. The weird incidents include the sighting of a gray figure, books flying off shelves, sweets forming a pattern on the floor, mysterious footsteps, and a key flying through the air. Mount Misery Road, and Sweet Hollow Road, New York, USA. Mount Misery Road and Sweet Hollow Road are famous scary roads near the town of Melville in Long Island. They say the place is haunted and there are lots of scary stories, legends and myths associated with the area. The first legend is that three teenage boys hanged themselves by hanging off of the Northern State Overpass Bridge on Sweet Hollow Road, in some kind of crazed suicide pact. They say that when you are driving down Sweet Hollow Road and pass under the bridge, if you honk your horn 3 times or flash your lights 3 times and look in your rearview mirror, you will see their lifeless bodies hanging from the overpass. There is another legend that on a dark and snowy night, a bus full of school children was crossing a bridge. The driver suddenly lost control, crashing on Sweet Hollow Road and killing everyone on board. Ever since then, people driving down the road at night have seen a group of faceless children walking along in the darkness. Others report seeing a bus full of children parked at night outside the graveyard. They say that if you drive under the bridge and put your car in neutral, the car will start to roll out from underneath the bridge. Some believe that this is the dead kids pushing your car out of harm's way. Mount Misery Road also has its fair share of supernatural tales to tell. It is said that back in the 1700s, there was a lunatic asylum on Mount Misery. At the time, care for the insane was rudimentary and cruel. The patients suffered brutal treatment and were abused terribly. They say you could hear their screams for miles around. One night, a female inmate set fire to her cell. Soon the entire mental asylum was in flames, and it burned down with all the patients and workers trapped inside. There have been reports that at night, you can see the ghostly figure of the woman who started the fire. She wanders down the side of the road, dressed in a white hospital gown, with messy, unkempt white hair. Sometimes, she jumps out in front of cars when they pass by. Some people claim to have seen burning ghosts fleeing from the grounds and heard their horrific screams and cries. Another urban legend about Sweet Hollow Road is that a police officer was shot and killed there years ago. They say that if you are driving on Sweet Hollow Road, sometimes you will get pulled over by the ghost of the dead cop. He comes over to your car, questions you and then lets you go. As the cop turns away and walks back to his car, you can see that the back of his skull is missing, blown out by a shotgun blast. Stocksbridge Bypass, Yorkshire, England. Linking Sheffield to Manchester, K. Construction began on the Stocksbridge bypass in 1987. Almost immediately after construction began, workers complained of eerie sights and sounds that defied rational thought. Workers reported hearing the giggling voices of children singing, and seeing them playing in a field where no child should be. On a number of occasions, construction staff had to stop working when their equipment inexplicably ceased to operate properly or failed altogether. And broken equipment wasn't the only thing that caused the construction to slow down. Workers were so scared, they walked off the job, never to return. Nevertheless, one night in particular turned up the horror, and two unsuspecting security guards were treated to an experience they would never forget. On a late night in 1987, two security guards were patrolling the construction site when they caught a glimpse of something out of the ordinary. Several children, dressed in old-fashioned clothing, were laughing and playing in the field where workers reported a similar incident. When the two guards rushed to question the children, they simply vanished, leaving the guards in stunned silence. They checked the area for any signs of the children but were unable to find even so much as a footprint. As they stood in the field, mystified by what they were experiencing, they became intensely aware they were being watched. Looking towards the newly constructed Pyramid Bridge, a terrifying sight met their eyes. Standing silently on the bridge, looking down at them, was the shadowy figure of a large man in a black robe and hood. His probing, malevolent eyes seemingly staring directly into their souls, causing a visceral feeling of fear. When the guards regained their senses, they jumped into their car and drove to the bridge, never taking their eyes off the strange man. When they pulled up behind him, their fear returned when they realized the lights passed through his heavy black robe. The hooded figure vanished, and the guards fled in terror. When they returned to the office, they were met by their supervisor, who could tell the two guards were shaken to their cores. Upon hearing their story, one that sounded like something out of a spine-chilling horror film, he called the police. Two police officers were dispatched to the worksite to look into the bizarre matter. They had no doubt the guards had seen something, but ghosts, how absurd. Their skepticism would soon come crashing down around them. Driving out to the site, the two veteran cops turned their car off and sat in silence, expecting to either see nothing, or maybe a couple of thieves intent on getting their hands on some planned equipment. After a quiet couple of hours, one officer broke the silence with a blood-curdling scream. His partner snapped his head around to see the torso of a man pressed against the window. The officer jumped out of the car to apprehend what he thought was someone playing a practical joke. But when he came around the front of the car, the figure vanished. The two officers were suddenly overcome with an intense feeling of dread, and frightening sounds filled the once quiet night. Convinced something strange was going on, they returned to the station and filed their report. In it, they detailed how before they vacated the site, they could hear the unmistakable sound of heavy fists banging on the roof of the car. Once construction had finished, there was no end to the reports of supernatural occurrences. Several eyewitnesses came forward with similar reports of ghostly activity along the bypass. Travelers have reported seeing spectral children playing in the field, as well as the phantom monk walking along the road, his head lowered in silent prayer. One couple in 1997 feared they ran a pedestrian over when he suddenly appeared in front of their car. When they got out to investigate, they found nothing. No injured person was anywhere to be found. Statistically, Stocksbridge Bypass has the worst record of automobile accidents in the UK. When reporting accidents, drivers stated that someone suddenly appeared before their cars, causing them to lose control. Maybe the ghosts of Stocksbridge Bypass delight in playing pranks on drivers. Or perhaps, it's a sinister plan to add to their numbers.